Nightfall in the Windy City with the Willis Tower and the rest of downtown Chicago lighting up the sky. You can hear the roar here at the United Center. Kevin Harlan here along with analysts Greg Anthony and Steve Smith. And we'll be hearing from DA along the sideline all game long.
The Chicago Bulls here to defend the home court playing host to the Western Conference.
Opening night, every team starting from scratch, Steve. That has a lot of people optimistic at this time of the year. Teams that favored coming into the season and teams that may not be looked upon very favorably.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, a lot of these teams, they look at it, maybe didn't have the season they wanted the previous season, maybe because of injuries, or maybe they just in jail. So as an organization, a fan base, you're excited in opening day. And then there are some teams, Kevin, that you look in and you go, ooh, we don't even have a chance, but let me just pretend like it, that we have a chance, and hopefully they can make a trade throughout the year.
Now Sacramento starting five. On the wings, Hield and Bogdanović. Down low, it's Bagley and Cauley-Stein. And it's Fox in at the point. Dunn passes to Markkanen. Passes to Carter. Levine against Hield. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's going to go on Willie Cauley-Stein.
A late bloomer in high school, Zach LaVine could still be just scratching the surface of his true ability.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And converted more than four out of every five free throw attempts last year. So just solid at the line.
Free throw good, LaVine.
Zach LaVine won back-to-back dunk contests in 2015 and 2016. The second one against Eric Gordon, an all-time classic.
And so LaVine nails both of them. And Dr. J said it best. Zach LaVine is among the greatest performers in dunk contest history.
LaVine doesn't actually dunk a whole lot in regular games. But when he gets out in transition, though, step back.
Yeah, the aggressive D inside leads to a missed opportunity there.
You know, he had terrific position. Does a good job of affecting the shot without fouling.
Now, here's Dunn. Out to Carter. Fires the three. Drills it from outside. Carter's got himself going there, his first points of the game on the deep ball.
What I like is when Chris Dunn keeps his poise, keeps his eyes up, good things happen.
There's the feed to Cauley-Stein. And Cauley-Stein throws it down.
This is a guy who knows how to orchestrate an offense. Terrific lead pass.
And here are the Bulls now. It's a three-point game. LaVine kicks to Parker. Markkanen sets the pick for Parker. It's stolen by Bagley. And now Sacramento on the break. Fox leading the charge. Hield can't hit.
And that was an easy one there. Just a missed opportunity.
If you give it to him, he'll take that shot every time down the floor. I'm sure he's kicking himself.
Now here's Parker. Bagley with the rebound. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it.
And taking a look now at stats for Cauley-Stein. He had a strong showing last season. He was around 12 points per game last year, 7 rebounds and 2 assists. And for a reserve big man, not a big drop-off when he checks in the game.
Totally. You want your team to at least hold court when the reserves come in. He definitely keeps you solid up front.
Now here's LaVine. Jabari Parker unable to get his last shot to go. And LaVine, here we go. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation. Bulls shooting their third free throw shot of the game.
And if we want to take a look back, they converted about 76% from the line.
And he shows the focus there, nails the technical.
And Lauri Markkanen, a seven-footer who can really let it fly. At Arizona, the most three-pointers ever by a seven-footer in a single season.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Bobby Portis has checked in for Carter. Valentine comes in for Jabari Parker. And Justin Holliday subbed in for Levine. Now, here's Dunn. Portis sets the pick for Dunn. Four on the clock. From past the arc. Second shot opportunity, and Holiday with the lay-in.
His combination of energy and anticipation showing up on the offensive glass.
Farrell kicks to Randall. He dishes it to Jackson. Randolph inside. Defended by Portis. Nice shot by Randolph. And Markkanen also setting records for three-pointers made by a rookie grade.
A quick release, the ball comes off his hands so effortlessly. He's more than a stretch big as well. I think he's a shooter who just happens to be 7 feet tall.
Now here's Jackson. Lauri Markkanen unable to get his last shot to go. And there's the foul. It's on Bobby Portis. That is his first foul of the game. Lopez, he's checked in for Chicago. There's 42 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. In the corner, Farrell. And stolen by Dunn. There's the pass to Valentine. Trying to get open is Lopez. And Valentine with the basket on the assist from Dunn. Valentine's got his first 2 points. Farrell kicks to McLemore. Randolph against Lopez. LeBissier with the screen for McLemore. And they pick up two.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Dunn outside. Here's Valentine. No good on the buzzer beater. And we reach the end of the first quarter. Bulls out front, up four. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. Bobby Portis, who's known for his work ethic, said he learned a lot from his mother.
She gets up at 3, 4 in the morning and gets off at 1, 2 in the evening. You know, she works hard for her four boys. You know, she breaks herself off daily. You know, I always try to pride myself in hard work also because how hard she worked for me.
And she was a basketball player in her own right. Greg, a scholarship at Jackson State University.
Yeah, and gave up basketball when she had Bobby, but she encouraged him to pursue his dream, and she said now she's living her dream through him.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And from what we've seen so far from the Bulls, what's your take?
I tell you what, that first quarter, you can see the game plan is a commitment to offensive rebound.
That's their mindset. And these extra possessions have been converted into a lead.
On the court for the Kings as the second quarter gets underway. Davis is out there with Zach Randolph. Then there's Jackson. Then it's McLemore. And it's Farrell in at the one. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Find the lane.
Well, the Kings signed some quality vets last season, but when the losses piled up, they decided to go young. Now, the focus is on development. The veterans still have a role, providing steadying presence on the court and in the locker room. Kevin?
David, it certainly is a balancing act. Thanks for that report.
You know, over the years, Zach Randolph has proven to be the perfect leader. He commands respect, and he gets it from his teammates.
Now, here is Holiday. Lopez sets a screen for Portis. Back to Holiday. Portis the screen. The shot by Holiday, no good. The Kings trail by three. Left side, Jackson. And it's Davis at the elbow. Now here's McLemore. No good, shot missing. Good D by Holiday. And there will be flashes when McLemore looks like the seventh overall pick in the draft, Steve, but they're right now few and far between.
Kevin, he hasn't quite broken through. The size and athleticism are there. Solid three-point shooter, but you never know exactly what kind of minutes he's going to give you.
And Sacramento has possession after the three-pointer from Zach LaVine. Left side, Randolph. Great D that time from Portis.
Uh-oh, he misses the bunny. I think he thought somebody was coming over to contest it.
Now, here's Valentine, guarded by Jackson. Lopez a screen. Valentine dishes to Lopez. Excellent use of the screen that time.
They've settled into a nice groove offensively here in the second.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Chicago. Carter, he's checked in for Lopez. Markkanen comes in for Bobby Portis, and Parker's subbed in for Justin Holiday. The Kings trail by eight. Heeled outside. A pass to Fox. Cauley-Stein with the screen for Fox. Back to Heeled. Good, and a nice assist from Fox. Steve, when you look back at your career, which years do you remember playing your best brand of basketball?
You know, I think obviously when you're younger, you feel like you have more of an impact with your skill level to go along with your athleticism. I think my best run was about a 5 or 6 year run when I was playing with the Atlanta Hawks and the Portland Trailblazers. Those two teams, I think I had my best run.
Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Valentine passes to Parker. And stolen by Cauley-Stein. And the Kings pushing it up now. Here's Heald. Finished off the break. Heald's got four this quarter.
How about the awareness there from Fox? You gotta love seeing how he is such a willing passer in finding the open man.
Now here's Markkanen. Bulls moving the ball around. Markkanen is screen on Fox. Now here's LaVine. Not a lot of room. Nobody near Parker. Good on the three-point shot.
It really turned it around here in the second quarter after shooting less than 40% from the field in the first.
Heald outside. Just five on the clock. Pass to Fox. Over LaVine. That one wide left. And so it's the Chicago Bulls bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. A good size advantage, and they'll look to increase it. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Dave Yeager. Coach, what is going to be the focus offensively going into the second half?
Well, we try to go inside. You know, that's our strength anyways. And for us, you know, our bread is buttered inside, so we try to play high-low. And then if the threes come out of that, great, but we want to try to get everything to the rim.
Coach, it all starts with that entry pass to the big, and then everybody plays off of him. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. It was a closely contested first quarter for Chicago. The biggest lead they were able to get out to during the first period was 6 points. Looking at the Bulls, how about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
You got to like their offense efficiency. They were patient, took good shots. That was reflected in their high field goal percentage. They just need to keep playing smart in the second half and close this thing out. Don't get cute now.
And Kenny, what'd you see from Sacramento?
I thought they were definitely outworked on the defensive end. They showed a lack of hustle, a lack of physicality. They weren't staying in front of their guys or putting bodies on people. It's critical that they improve their defensive effort in the second half.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
Kenny.
Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.